I know I'm completely late to this tag. I was tagged in it in November and it's now January, but... Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kara and today I'm going to be doing the Thank You Next book tag that was... Gratefully, I was tagged in by my friend Grace, who is G's with Books here on YouTube, so I'll leave her channel link below. And this is just a series of questions based on Ariana Grande's Thank You Next song. And... I've got to do them. So without further ado, let's get into it. If you are tagged, you'll be tagged at the end of this video and you'll also be tagged in the description below. So make sure you check it out. And even if you're not tagged, just do the questions anyway. The first question is, name a book that you said thank you next to, i.e. a book you did not finish. Now I don't have this book anymore because I brought it from the library, but it is The One Memory of Flora Banks. I did finish this, but I was so close to not finishing it. I had heard so much about this book and I wanted to read it for a while, and when I saw it at the library I thought I'll borrow it because if I don't like it I'm glad like I didn't spend the money on it. And I hated it. It was so boring. It was so slow. Like, I hated picking it up and the end made no sense. Like, the story was just building up to this massive plot change and then nothing happened. So does that count? I did not finish it. I didn't even enjoy it. I almost didn't finish it, but I like having satisfaction of finishing a book. So does that count? Question number two, it says you can answer the next three questions together or separately. I'm going to answer them separately with a different book. So number three, name a book that taught you love. Of course, Everything Everything by Nicole Yoon. I love this book. It is just such a good book. I did a review on this about 2 years ago, I think. I read this before the movie came out, but this is a story all about a girl called Maddie who is allergic to everything, you know, everything, everything. And she falls in love with a boy called Ollie and who lives next door, and it's just beautiful. It's such a beautiful book, and there's a plot twist, and then it makes you hate someone, but like, it taught me to love, you know, without boundaries. Book that definitely taught me patience is Lying About Last Summer by Sue Wollman. This is a Zola book club book, but this is about a girl called Skye whose sister tragically passes away, and it's just her story of how she deals with it and stuff. Now, the reason this taught me patience is because the character pissed me off so much. I almost didn't finish this book because I couldn't like deal with the character. She was so whiny and annoying and she complained about everything. It was, oh, poor me, poor me, poor me. But it taught me patience because I got to the end and I finished it, and it was a plot twist and it was good, but it taught me patience to get there. So number five is a book that taught you pain, and it is this, Before I Go by Colleen Oakley. This is about a girl called Daisy who has been diagnosed with terminal cancer, and before she goes, she wants to find her husband a new wife. And this book killed me. Like, it broke my heart so much. It was literally like someone had just taken a knife and shoved it into my heart. Like, she had so much just love and dedication to wanting to do this for her husband. But like, in the end, it was like, you know, she was doing it out of a good, like, the goodness of her heart, and it's just, and I'm gonna sneeze. Like, all her husband wanted was to just be with her and love her for all the time he had left, and it was just like... Number six, name a book that you loved at the time of reading, but in hindsight, you do not like as much anymore. And of course, I had to choose this. It is Looking for Alaska by John Green. I used to love John Green when I was, like, 15. I think every 15-year-old girl did, but this... It's just not that good. Like, I think obviously at the time I was just picking these really cheesy YA books, which I still read YA, so I can't really talk, but it just, I have flicked through it to reread once, and it's just, it's really like, it's not well written. It just doesn't flow as well as I like remember it being. Did they make a movie out of this one? Was that Paper Towns or both movies? I can't really remember, but just meh. That's how I feel about this book now. Just meh. Number seven, name a book that you're currently talking to, i.e. a book you're currently reading. A book that I am currently reading is a book from the Tales of a New World series. And this is the second book. It is Psalm Warrior. I was kindly sent these by Pam McMillan last year. And I'm finally getting onto it. I'm like just over halfway through now. I absolutely love it. I love the character Mari. She's such like a badass like girl, and she knows what she wants and she stands up for her, like, herself and her, like, her tribe. But I'm really loving this one. I'm kind of liking this one more actually than the first one. But if you haven't read the series, definitely check it out. It's a really good like fantasy read. And number eight, name a book that's gone last, the book of you, the book that helped you love yourself a little bit more. And this is so cringy and I don't even care, but the first like actual book series that I ever read was Twilight, and I still love Twilight. Like, I know they are so shit and everything, but I can't resist a little Twilight, a little Edward Cullen. Like, he's my favorite. I reckon one day I might reread it and just realize like how kind of crap they were. But when you were 14, this was just like, it was just your life. So I actually became best friends with my, you know, my best friend in year 8 over this book. And we've been friends for 10 years this year. So I'd say that's pretty good odds for a book about a vampire and, you know, just the girl next door. I'm going to be tagging for this video is, one, I'm going to be tagging my good friend Amelia. Number two, I'm going to be tagging Rhiannon, who is a new BookTube friend I've made through Bookstagram. So I've made, you know, a Books Instagram. If you want to follow that, I'll leave it on the screen, but it'll also be in the description now. So Amelia, Rhiannon, and also Kat and Victoria. So if you would like to do this tag, the questions are in the description below. If you've been tagged, please do it. I'd love to see your responses to these questions. And without further ado, thank you. Goodbye. Just joking. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe, because we're so close to 800 subscribers. And I'd love to get there. So please, please. And I'll see you all in another video next week. Goodbye. Thank you.